Hi, this is Russ Anderson. This is the second tutorial in focus breathing, so I'm going to go a little quicker through some parts. This is a literal toy shot, similar to handheld rack focus shots, with actors as the subject. This was shot with an iPhone 13 Pro with a Moment 1.33x anamorphic converter. We'll start by setting up some tracking parameters. We do have plenty of detail back there, but of course much of it is out of focus a lot of the time. Meanwhile, back on the solver panel, it does need to be a tripod solve since there's not much of any motion available. And it is a zoom due to the rack focus. So to keep things nailed down, we'll go to the end of the shot and set up some constraints to keep the solve from wandering. And we'll shorten the shot up. That's just a shift drag of that. And we can do our initial solve just for those particular frames. I'm going to hit J to hide the X's, and I'll just pick out some trackers to use as constraints so that the whole shot doesn't fold up later. Okay. Now, again, we're going to use anamorphic merged mode, and we'll put the vertical scaling into animate by frame mode to start out with. We'll turn on the constrain, and we do want to solve the entire shot now. And it's just going to be a refine. So there we go. And now we can look at the field of view that's been computed. And of course, our vertical scaling value as well. So that's our initial solution. And you'll notice that there's a bit of jitter to that. And of course, we haven't done any tracker cleanup, but just to eliminate that as a nicety, we'll go to the tracker room and we'll set up for a little tracker cleanup. Oops. See right there, there's one particularly bad tracker already. Let's just take it out for starters. And now we'll select our trackers. Run the cleanup trackers. We're going to do this in HPix mode, and we'll select the trackers that we're going to wipe out. And as you decrease the threshold, you start seeing ones that look better and better. So I don't know, we'll just take somewhere in there. And maybe we'll take out some of the bad frames also, just on general principle. So that's some initial tracker cleanup for us. And now we can go and refine that solution. And you'll see that the error is quite a bit lower. And here are our curves. And you notice that we still have this jitter sitting around. And the more parameters that we're solving for, And the fewer trackers that you have, the more jitter that's going to be present in the solution. And that jitter then can wind up being applied to the 3D things that you're inserting into the shot. So it's a bad thing, ultimately. On some shots, it may not be an issue. On other shots, it might. So we have a way to address this in the solver that's particularly effective and kind of data-driven, and that is to have it do solves right at keys. So, you know, we could try and do some filtering to this, but ultimately filtering isn't super effective. It starts to do too much. Whenever you try and do too strong a filtering in some areas, it starts, you know, smushing out other spots too much. So what we're going to do is kind of a more insightful sort of way to it, if you like. And to do that, we're going to just go and start deleting keys from the shot. And we're just going to have the solver solve for some particular set of frames. So we're actually controlling where the solutions get done. And we can do that based on that initial solution that we got with the frame-by-frame animation, which might be really incredibly noisy, but at least tell us where's the focus happening. You know, where do we need to put our efforts, some more keys to be able to address that. There's also a script that's kind of a less insightful way of doing this that lets you add keys, you know, every couple of frames. You can do keys every 10 frames, say, just as a initial way to try and nail things down. And that's, you know, might be an approach if the animate by frames doesn't let you actually, you know, isn't stable enough to let you get a solution. Maybe if you reduce the number of spots that you're actually doing the solution, that might be more stable. But so we've cut down where we're getting the solve being done. We can go refine it again. We look back here. And the thing that's really cool about this mode is that it's computing where to put these keys, taking into account all these intermediate frames, you know, both before and after each key, to decide what the optimal placement is for those keys that optimizes all of the frames. So that's really cool. And if you go and say, oh, you know, hey, I need to get some more detail, you know, in some particular area, you can go and do that just by adding some keys back in and now going and refining the solve again. And you see that it starts to bring out that additional detail. This is the basic solution with a zoom and the vertical scaling. Now let's go and see what we can do to remove the zoom if that's what the end user customer wants. So to do that, we're going to go back. We're going to change the mode to known. We're not going to keep our field of view around, but we are going to make sure that we've got our 75 degrees throughout the entire length of the shot. And we're going to put our horizontal scaling value at, in a mode at the same animated keys mode. Now, when we go and look at it in the graph editor, you know, you see it doesn't have any keys on it to start with. But we can just hold down Control and hit this Add Keys button, and it will go and add keys on each of these frames for each of the animated keys parameters throughout the shot. So we just added those keys at the same spots of interest throughout the shot for this new parameter that we're solving. So now with that done, we can go back to our solver. We'll just solve again. And now we get our solution. For this, and the curves for the horizontal scale versus the field of view, it's a bit different. They're kind of inverses of one another. So you see some kind of interesting things a little bit. But you know, now if you decide actually that you want to, let me get this back, that you want to add some additional keys at some spot, now you can just hit that add keys there. It'll add them in. And again, you can go and refine the solution again and, you know, continue to develop detail in places where you think that you need it based on what you're seeing from the solve. So from these two curves, you notice that there's not a whole lot of difference between the horizontal and vertical scaling with this 1.33x anamorphic lens. That the lenses are all going to differ in, based on the lens characteristics itself, and also, you know, how much of a focus pull is involved, and so on. So hopefully this has given you a better understanding of how to handle lens breathing. Now, your own shots are going to be different. Don't expect to hit the same buttons blindly. You know, without a focus backgrounds, you may have many fewer features to track, and supervised tracking is going to be essential, along with the animated keys mode. So Synthize gives you the tools to address these problems. Good luck, and thanks for watching.